2021 has been a huge success for the leadership of the Ikoyi Obalende local council area, with unprecedented achievements recorded. To build on these feats in the coming year, the leadership hosted a consultative forum as stakeholders, traditional rulers, residents, and party leaders converged on the Ijere Primary Health Care Center to deliberate on the 2022 budget. Speaking at the meeting, the council chairman, Fuad Atondalawao, said the annual ritual aims at rubbing minds with the grassroots so round pegs can be put in round holes, noting that 2021 has been outstanding in the delivery of the dividends of democracy.
For us at the Ikoyi Obalende LCD, it has always been about the people, about the people, about the people. And that's why we continue to come up with projects that would affect the lives of the common man, the underserved within the local council development area, the people at the bottom of the food chain, to see how we can provide for them. And we continue to conduct our own needs assessments to get what feedback from our people. If you say you would want rice, we're not going to give you yam. To understand your needs. And that's the whole essence of the budget stakeholders forum, where we talk, we exchange ideas. You tell us the things that we did last year, how it hasn't affected your own community, and how you think going forward. You want us to intervene. You want us to come together with you, to partner with you, to make everything work. And that's what this whole thing is all about. The last 4 years have been very good. We give God all the glory. It is not by our power, but it is by the special grace of God that we're able to do those things that we did in the last 4 years. And I know that the next 4 years is equally going to be amazing. It's definitely going to be awesome. And that's why we're here today, to see how we can partner with everyone and deliver on our campaign promises, deliver on the SDGs, that is Sustainable Development Goals, to see how people can understand, know that the government is always here for our people. We're here to work with you. This is the government that is closest to the grassroots. This is the government that you can come to the office to say you want to see someone. Even if you're not going to see the chairman, you can see the vice chairman, you can see the council manager, you can see the councillors, you can see everybody, and they will bring your matter forward, because we continue to help in this regard.
Pamphlets were distributed to ward representatives as they itemized some of their requests. Other fractional and ward representatives commended the leadership for attending to most of the demands made at the 2020 stakeholders meeting. They also mentioned a few challenges that needed attention. Responding to the requests, the council chairman stressed the importance of taking ownership of the infrastructure and facilities that have been put in place, assuring that efforts are on to boost the internally generated revenue and attend to most of the outlined needs. He reiterated his administration's commitment to serving the people at the bottom of the food chain and implementing policies that will affect the entire populace positively.
But I just want to implore again that the ones we did in the election streets, we are not happy with what we are saying. We are not maintaining the road. After the road that has been completed, we went back there and handed over. We went back there, most of all of the things that we put there. And that this morning, they sent me a picture of a drainage filled with plastic waste. We are not the ones pouring these things here. So if we are going to embark on any capital project of such in Obalende again, they must be able to maintain the one that we've done already. If they don't maintain that one, we won't do any other road there. You have to maintain it. It's very bad that we are spending so much money. And before we even leave office, these things are going bad. You need to support us on this road. It's not easy to put 20 million, 10, 15, how many million together just to fix roads. But if you don't maintain the road, it's going to be very bad. The stakeholders meeting we had at Alausa the other day, all of the things that they proposed are things that we've done already in Obalende. From street lights to road projects to water projects to internet, so many things that we've done. PXC, we have everything in Obalende. But please, if you don't maintain this thing, we can't guarantee that we will move to site on any other project. Maintain this one. If you are happy with what you have done, then we'll come back to you to say we want to do more. Obalende, before, when we came in 2017, Ojo Street was gone. Ojo was gone, election was gone. Obalende Road was gone. And so right now, Ojo Street was We can see just in 4 years, you know, the streets that are back normal, it's not up to three again. Moshalashi, we touched it because it wasn't like a fully, we did the sectional patching. That was what we did for Eleshi, for Moshalashi. So please, help us so we can help you. The other thing, most the useless roads in Obalende, just 2 roads out of 7. Just 2 roads, that is Ajenia and Odo. Toya is good. So what we have to fix on Toya is just sectional patching. And to be fine, it's motorable again. So what A people, you're my people, we have no other place to go. Obalende is our home, Obalende is our village. But please support us so we can help do more for the good people of Obalende. We want to fix the roads, but please maintain what we have done so far.
The CDC chairman, Yemisi Shodipo, in an interview, expressed confidence that the requests made by the people will be attended to, while commending the leadership's effort towards a progressive LCDA.
I'm very confident in the leadership of Fuad Nagodalawa, as was manifested in all the testimonies that was given from all the wards, and all what the prayers and encouragement which we further move in to perform better. On my own and on behalf of all the CDA members and the citizens, we give honorable Fuad Nagodalawa.
The people of Ikoyi-Obalende LCDA can look forward to another year of sustained development.